Ladies and gentlemen, I want you on your feet and screaming for Mike LaRocco!
I raced professionally for 19 seasons, and I'm just trying to use my experience to, you know, help lead these guys to championships. My name is Mike LaRocco. I'm with Geico Honda. I'm the team manager here. I was introduced to CrossFit in 2011 with a friend of mine, and you know, I was interested in, you know, bringing it to the team and having the guys you know, get the value of it. So in doing so, I wanted to make sure I did a little homework. You know, I went to a regular CrossFit box and I did the L1. I just learned as much as I could about it so that if, you know, the guys had questions or, you know, if I'm going to put a stamp on it, you know, I wanted to know more about it. My role is to try to learn each individual rider and what's going to be best for them. And as a whole, I feel like most guys are going to have the most benefit with, you know, finding the ability to suffer, learn how to control it. I mean, our sport is grueling. I mean, you have injuries to ride through and the heat and the, you know, there's a ton of suffer, and you just got to learn how to deal with it. And that's what attracts me about CrossFit.
The FC Honda CrossFit gym is awesome. You know, they went above and beyond. Just to see the amount of work that was put into it and to see it now at the end of the day and people using the gym now. It's just cool to walk in there, you got your number hanging on the wall, and it's just motivating. Little stuff like that is what drives you to come to the gym and look forward to doing a WOD. And you know, if it's one of those workouts you just hate doing, it eases that. I've done CrossFit quite a bit. I feel like when you're behind the gate with 22 other guys and you don't like any of those people, you just want to beat them. And I feel like you get that in a CrossFit gym when you go do a WOD. You do it for time and all you want to do is beat them, you know? So you kind of get that same mindset where it just kicks in and that's what I like about CrossFit is the intensity. I think CrossFit will help mainly with my mentality. Just to be a stronger athlete. If you know you're strong in the gym and you can do all these workouts and bench this much, you know you can do all that. So you go behind the gate and you're like, well, you know, I'm stronger than this guy. You know, I'm just all around better than this guy. So then it's just at the end of the day, it's just like a mentality thing. That's kind of the motocross thing, is the strong-minded end up doing the best. And that's what a lot of people are missing in their program.
Here comes Martin on the final lap.
This is going to be a massive confidence booster.
And Jeremy Martin becomes the first repeat winner in the 250 East Championship in 2016.
You know, CrossFit to me, it's wide open, it's intense, and you know, it's crazy because, you know, like I felt like I was like pretty fit, you know, and then for dirt bikes, but you know, I mean, that's a whole nother level, like between the handstands and that's all above, it's above me. You know, I have no really idea what CrossFit was, but everyone there took the time to explain CrossFit and to show us the movements and we took it slow, and then we brought the intensity into it, and then it was a really good fun atmosphere. And I think a lot of us, you know, we're still talking about it, and it's been enjoyable. Like with the Geico Honda team and the CrossFit, I see it it being a beneficial program. You know, and the number one thing for me is it's results. So for me, I'll do whatever it takes to get first and to get that good result. So if it means I have to do CrossFit two or three times a week, or if it means whatever it may be, I'm gonna do it. Or if I have to go and I have to, you know, bike up some big mountain, I'm gonna do it. So whatever is gonna be the most beneficial thing for my program is what I believe I need to do.
Like I said, I reference CrossFit workouts to some of the actual races, in the sense that, you know, especially even how they start, like CrossFit, you get the time countdown, it's 3, 2, 1, go, you know, which is much the same as the gate dropping, and it's kind of an all-out effort until you're done, right, which is exactly like a race. So, and then the muscle fatigue part, you know, a lot of people don't really understand how much activity is involved. I mean, you're always constantly squatting and pulling and pushing, you know, when you're riding the bike, and that's why I relate it so much to the CrossFit, is because you're always doing something of that nature at high intensity, and it's a race. So to me, completely relevant. in my sense of coaching in that statement, it was more about like I'm trying to give the guys the right direction for their careers, their riding, the stuff that they don't know they need to know yet. And it's just, you know, it's tough in this sport because everybody, it's a family-based sport, or it's a, you know, people, it's an individual sport. So everybody comes up with somebody as their right-hand man or their whatever. So everybody has a lot of different views of what works and what doesn't. And I think, you know, unfortunately, it takes a lot of guys, you know, a long time to figure it out, and a lot of failed careers missing the boat, you know. So I'm just trying to get the guys a shortcut and give them the right information. There's some guys that know about the suffering. There's some guys that pull back and don't suffer, and those guys are yet to be successful. You know, there's that fine line. You do what you can, and then you're not successful. It's the guys that are finding a way to deal with the suffer that are making it happen. And until you're ready to make that commitment, it's not likely. And it's usually because everybody hurts, but everybody feels like they hurt worse than the next guy, but it's really who's gonna deal with it most. And so if you don't hear that from the guys, it's because they don't know it yet. As I look forward to this season and these guys' experience in CrossFit, I think there's, what I'd hope that they get out of it is when you do your training and then you go to the race, the intensity at the race is always higher. You can't match it on your own. As soon as that gate drops, it's 100% intensity. And I hope that by doing CrossFit and having the competition as they train in the preseason, that won't be such a shock to them, you know, come start the season. And I want them to learn how to suffer all week long so that the weekends aren't that bad. So it doesn't sound like a fun thing for me to want them to do, but they're gonna reap the benefits.